discussion on carburetors, basically by Dr. Faisal Ahmed. And what I can say is carburetor is a device whose function is to supply proper fuel air ratio to the cylinder at various speed, various loads, and this is the major function of carburetor. And you can see in the diagram showing the principle how this is the fuel is being supplied and this is the air is being supplied at this end, and the air fuel ratio has been mixed and it is being supplied to the engine. This is the function of carburetor. Now second part is how it works. How it works is air is entering from this here, and from this point the fuel is being supplied, kept here. This portion, this is the needle is being provided, and this complete portion of the air is filled. You can see this portion. This is a spring for various adjustment and for air screw and other purposes. And then this is a throttle. Throttle means to increase the fuel supply. That is the throttle valve has been used here. So this is throttle slide. Then this is a pit out tube which has been applied to it, and where the fuel air mixture has been combined and been sent to the engine. This is the basic principle of a carburetor. Now types of carburetor, how they work. This presentation is from HGI Bhopal, and this is a diagram showing carburetor of an engine. You can see it here directly. This is how it looks actually. Now, performance objectives. Student will be able to understand the working of carburetors. We will be able to list and describe the common types of small engine carburetors. These are things, principle of operations, nature of side draft, up draft, down draft. These are definitions we will be able to understand it. How many you know where the carburetor locator on your lawn mower? If you have seen a lawn mover enter above or below the gas tank, does it really matter where it is located? And nature and side draft, up draft, then this is natural draft. What we can see, natural draft is automatically, for example, air water tanks have been kept on the upper portion of our house, and automatically water enters into all the taps. So this is called natural draft. Here, where there is space on the top of the engine, the air horizontally into the manifold. Like in mostly bikes, natural draft carburetor has been used mainly because due to gravitational force, fluid automatically flows, and this is somewhat a diagram for the same. Now, secondly, we have updraft. This type is placing the low on the engine and use a gravity-fed fuel supply. In other words, the tank is above the carburetor and the fuel falls to it. These are updraft carburetors. Then downdraft carburetor. This carburetor operates with lower air velocities and large pressures. This is because gravity assists the air fuel mixture flow to the cylinder. This is downdraft carburetors. Then downdraft carburetors can provide large volume of fuel when needed for high speed and high power output. Air is coming from upward, and this is see downdraft carburetor has. There updraft carburetors, you can see in the lawn movers, when a carburetor uses gravity to receive the fuel from the tank, the air fuel mixture must be forced upward into the engine. Then float type carburetors. Float is a small steel vessel made of brass or plastic. It maintains a constant level of fuel in the float bowl. This is a float bowl, you can see it here. This is a float bowl, as you can see it. It has been kept into it. It has been fixed with this covering casing. And as and when the value or level of the fuel goes down, this float goes down, and more fuel is being. The lid is open, and the more fuel enters into it. And this is how the fuel level is being constant. Now choke is around the disc mounted on a shaft at the intake end of the carburetor. At the intake, choke coil is being used. Initially, we have used in automobiles the choke coil when during the start of the engine, especially during the cold start. We use this choke coil. We pull the choke of the engine, and so that the air supply is being reduced, and more and more fuel enters it. So the more and more fuel enters it, the starting problem will be rectified, and engine starts easily because more the fuel, it will catch fire easily. Then float type carburetors. These are a type of a carburetor, a sort of classification, opening and closing a needle, a valve as a float lower if this is it. Then we have choke. Since cold fuel is hard to vaporize, the choke is used during cold engine starts to provide a rich mixture to the carburetor in order to get engine started. Then we have this total. The total is around this, mounted on the shaft beyond the main fuel nozzle in the carburetor. You can see this total when the air fuel, this is the air is entering, this is fuel entering, and this is total. Means air fuel mixture completely has been covered by throttle. Controlled by this throttle. Now load adjustment. Many carburetors take up a fixed jet and orifice which is present to allow the proper amount of load. These carburetors are non-adjustable. Now the adjustment can be done it by various nozzle. Now this is primer. Many small engines have hand operated plunger called a primer. When depressed, it forces additional fuel through the main nozzle prior to starting a cold engine. During cold starting, there's a lot of problem has been faced. So additional fuel has been supplied, which is called priming. Okay. Now this diaphragm carburetor, this type does not have a float, rather a difference between the atmospheric pressure and the vacuum created in the engine pulsates a flexible diaphragm. Then diaphragm carburetor, the pulsation of diaphragm takes place on every intake and compression stroke. Then throttle controls, the basic manual throttle control consists of either mechanical linkage or flexible cable. Then throttle controls, linkage manually opens and closes the throttle valve to obtain desired engine speed. This throttle has been mainly controlled by linkages and wires, as we have seen this. All engines have one of the following type carburetor: natural side draft, up draft, and down draft. These are the basic three types of carburetors available. Nature or side draft carburetor used when there is little space on the top of the engine. The air flows horizontally into the manifold, mainly in cars we prefer. The updraft carburetor is placed in the low on the engine, uses gravity fed fuel system. The downdraft carburetor operates with a lower air velocity and larger pressure, provides larger volume of fuel if needed. Some carburetors are either float type or diaphragm carburetors. The float type uses a float to maintain a constant level of fuel in the fuel bowl. The diaphragm carburetor uses different pressure. So for today it is okay, simple basic knowledge.